So we're taking this weight vector of w's and taking the dot product with the feature weights. If the weights are all zero, it's always going to predict zero, which is actually the correct answer for this MDP. So this, it's really easy to set the weights so that happens. Is that the only way to set the weights to make this happen?
No, because in fact, for each one of those states, there's only two features that are turned on, and there are different two features for every state except for state zero. So you could be pretty clever about it. So I think if you make the weight for zero minus one, maybe, and then make features one through six one half, that would get you zero for everything except state seven, and then state seven just needs it to be seven.
Seven or a seventh?
Seven.
Seven, good. So in particular, this weight vector times this feature vector is going to give us, well, minus seven plus zero plus zero plus zero plus zero plus seven, so zero.
Mm-hmm.
For this other one, it's going to give us minus one plus zero plus zero plus zero plus zero plus zero plus zero plus one, which is zero. So yeah, so this is a weight vector. So not only can we represent the value function, but we can represent it in multiple different ways. It is multiply representable, which I spelled wrong. Multiply, which is spelled the same as multiply, but it's representable in at least two ways.
Actually, an infinite number of ways, because you could take that vector, minus one, one half, one half, one half, whatever, seven, and multiply it by any constant, including zero, and it'll work.
Oh, nice. Multiply it by zero, you get that first weight vector that we talked about. Anything else that we get, we're multiplying zero times a constant. So in fact, there's an infinite set of weight vectors that all capture the optimal value function, which is all zeros. And so, you know, we have plenty of rope. We should be able to build a rope ladder.
Yeah, hang ourselves.
Oh, ultimately, that's actually what's going to happen in this case.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it seems quite friendly, right? It's also tiny, right?
Yeah.
These are all things that seem like it should make it so that it's really easy to get this right.
So then let's get it right.
Yeah, well, so it turns out that what Baird showed is that if you give it the right sequence of updates, it will actually spiral out of control. So let's take a look at that.
Okay.